Good morning, Sherlock.
Good morning, Mrs. Hudson.
Would you like some tea?
I'd love some, thank you.
The kettle's on the stove. I'm not your maid. Morning, Sherlock.
Good morning, John.
Redbeard. So, what are we doing today?
I have planned an entire day of studying the combat tactics of the samurais of Japan. This sword, for example, is over 600 years old and was owned by one of the greatest emperors in all of feudal Japan. His name was Takashi Ozawa. He was one of the best fighters I've ever seen.
What's that?
It's an email from an astronaut at the International Space Station.
Space Station? What?
Yes, his name is Jack Swigert, and he wanted me to look over a message that he intercepted. In this email from Jack Swigert, he gives a cryptic message written in Russian, and he isn't able to translate it, so he emailed me. If you give me a second, I will translate this message. And yes, I do speak Russian.
Of course you do.
Fascinating. Absolutely fascinating.
Please, enlighten me.
This message that Jack Swigert got from the Russian radio details a bit of information that Russian spies had lost. They had tried to find it, but the case went dead. They keep referring to something they're trying to find as the beacon on a hill. And they gave us a GPS coordinate for any Russian spies to go find another clue that'll lead them to this beacon on a hill. We need to find this beacon, in order to beat the Russians at their own game.
Where are the coordinates leading to?
The Colorado State Capitol. Perfect.
What about my breakfast?
You can eat it along the way, John. Let's go. Come on!
I'll never get my breakfast. What about John time? What about John Watson time? So, see any good movies recently?
I saw this great comedy. It's called The Life of John Watson.
Funny. Funny, Sherlock. You can't just have a decent conversation with your best friend.
I thought it was funny.
Don't forget your hat.
I don't want to wear the hat.
You're Sherlock Holmes. Wear the damn road hat.
Come on, John. The game is on.
Wait, Redbeard! Come back!
Anything else on you?
Nope.
Nothing else?
I'm clean.
Okay, you have a good day.
Thank you. Sherlock! Left me behind, with the security. What are we doing here?
The email that we received from Jack Swigert had a GPS location that led us to this spot. Somewhere in the Colorado General Assembly, there is a connection between the Russians and the Colorado State Legislature. You have to find this connection, something to do between the Russians and Colorado.
The Russians?
Yes.
And the Coloradans?
Trust me, John, it's here. It's either in a painting or a bust or something. We need to find it, and it's in this general area.
Well, this building is full of paintings and busts. Where do we look?
The third floor.
The third floor? Of course the third floor.
In Russian tradition, most sacred things happen on the third floor, such as when Vladimir Putin was put into power, his inauguration was on the third floor. When the czars were coronated, they were always on the third floor. It
third
has to be here, John.
Okay.
All right, let's
to
go.
The
let's
third
go.
Floor.
Absolutely.
All right, go.
Presidents. Paintings of presidents. Connection between Russia and the presidents. It's gotta be here. It's gotta be.
Sherlock!
What is it?
William McKinley. McKinley, that was
course. He was the one who bought Alaska from Russia.
The one who bought Alaska from Russia.
And this right here, Lawrence Williams, he was a Russian artist that was born in the US but still had close Russian ties even to his death. In fact, I believe that he has an autobiography in the Denver Library.
The Denver Library? Of course.
That's where we need to go. There's a clue there.
Of course there's
come
a clue.
Come on, come on! First female graduate from Johns Hopkins University and a member of the Colorado General Assembly. We need to go to Fairmount Cemetery, which is where she's buried, and then bet there's a clue there. Let's go.
Harry, John, let's try to find a clue. Anything to relate Florence Sabin with the country of Russia or the Colorado General Assembly.
Man, look at this detail on this mausoleum. This is incredible.
Yes, it's fascinating, John. Just try to keep focus.
Ha! Sherlock!
What'd you find?
Russian box.
A old piece of paper.
What's it say?
I can't read it.
You can't read it?
It's in an ancient dialect of Russian. I can't translate it. But I know someone who can.
Who?
His name's Kevin Cooney. He lives in the US.
American?
Yes, American. And he's probably one of the only people in the world who can actually understand what's written on this page.
An American who can translate ancient Russian?
Don't insult all Americans. You're not that great yourself.
Well, great. On that note, plane tickets. We need to get to America.
We do. Onward.
Onward.